Number 11 on the field, number one in my heart.
Hey, don't mess it up this time. Bro, what was that? Hello? Doctor, after you. I don't feel so good.
What's poppin', Patriots? I'm Jacob Dubin.
And I'm Serena Doshi.
And welcome to the very first episode of the Beckman Beat. We are super excited to be your hosts this year. Am I right, Serena?
Yeah, and we're even more excited to be working with our amazing crew.
That's right. This year, we've got an incredible crew working behind the scenes.
Here's a little introduction to the Beckman Beat leadership team.
Are you bored and have trouble entertaining yourself? Do you feel disconnected from other students at your school? Do you find it hard to get information on sports, events, and clubs? Well, look no further, because I have the product for you. I'm Nick Brokarmartian, and let me show you Beckman Beat.
We work tirelessly every day to make sure Beckman Beat is as enjoyable and efficient as humanly possible. And to show you how we can do that, and the positive side effects of watching Beckman Beat, let me introduce to you Daniel Lee, our chief scientist.
Thanks, Nick. Beckman Beat should be administered to those having issues with fatigue, boredom, hatred of school spirit, and illnesses. Yo, where are the subtitles? Side effects may include obsession with the show, excessive laughter, and illnesses? Is that in there? Compared to last year's BTV, the Beckman Beat is forecasted to bring viewership levels of 347% compared to last year. Now, here's Tyler Brown, our chief, what is that? Chief editor, executive officer. This doesn't make sense. All right, just here's our editor.
Thanks, Daniel. Here at the Beckman Beat, we try our best to create the highest quality product for the best results. We spend precious time to make our products and satisfy consumers. Now, here's our lead social media director, Ivana.
Thanks for that, Tyler. The Beckman Beat product will be available on multiple platforms, including our YouTube channel, Beckman Media Arts. You'll also be able to view our product on our Instagram page at beckman.beat. Thank you for tuning into this week's infomercial. Stay tuned for more.
We're also going to be working with our super talented... What?
Nothing. I mean, super talented, maybe like somewhat talented.
Jacob.
Sorry.
Our super amazingly talented man of the street, Luke Engstrom.
Oh, hi. I didn't see you there. Just kidding. I did see you there. For those of you who don't know, my name's Luke Engstrom, and I'm this year's man on the street. However, unfortunately, due to the current circumstances, I can't be your man on the street. However, I can be your man on the seat. Today I'm joined by our wonderful sportscaster, Nicolette Turner. Nicolette Turner, how are you doing on this fine evening?
Incredible. And yourself?
I'm doing great. So Nicolette, you're on volleyball, correct?
Yes.
So, if your team is still practicing right now, how are you guys staying safe during these COVID times?
Well, we aren't allowed to practice indoors right now, but we are doing weight room and conditioning twice a week with temperature checks, and we're practicing social distancing.
That's great. When would you say we could expect sports to go back to a somewhat normal state?
The earliest you'll be hearing about any sports action will be mid-December.
I see.
So Nicolette, with no sports this semester, when can we expect to see you on the show?
I'll be on the show with any updates on minor sports events, such as practices or tryouts, or with any CIF updates.
Well, aside from the sports stuff, Nicolette, how do you feel about landing the role of sports anchor this year?
I'm really excited. I'm really excited to see the show come to life and to work with the team.
That's great. You know, do you wish you got any of the other anchor roles?
Absolutely not. Do you?
No, not at all.
Awesome.
Well, Nicolette, thank you so much for joining me tonight.
Thank you for having me.
I'll be seeing you guys on the next Man on the Street.
And I'll keep you posted with the latest sports updates.
Back to you in the studio.
Thanks, Luke and Nicolette. Stay tuned for more sports.
Next up, we have a special sneak peek at a mystery series that you guys will have a chance to take part in.
And if I'm not mistaken, this segment is headed by you, Jacob.
That's right.
I'm glad my somewhat talented co-host is getting his chance. Let's take a look.
Why am I here?
You know why you're here. Monday, August 31st, 7:02 a.m. Four different teachers came to school that day to find their televisions smashed. You can imagine that I was pretty upset. So, I went back to my office and I looked through everything. All of the security footage leading up to that morning. Until I saw it. Gotcha. Wanna know what I saw?
I can explain.
We're going to have to expel you.
Wait! This is a mistake. I don't know who did this, but I can figure it out. I understand this looks bad. Really, but I promise you, it wasn't me. Just give me a week, and I'll find out who did this.
After each episode of this gripping mystery, you guys will get a chance to decide where the story goes next. I'm super excited, and I hope you guys are too.
You know what? I'm pleasantly surprised. I expected far worse, but now I'll make sure to vote for the next episode on Beckman Beat's Instagram. I think you might have a bright future, Jacob.
Of course I do. That's why I always wear sunglasses.
Maybe I should try that, because my eyes have been killing me with all this digital learning, and I'm sure it's been just as hard for all of you guys at home.
Yeah, it's been a struggle for all of us, especially for our great teachers who are making it possible.
If only those teachers could fix my Wi-Fi.
I swear, if I disconnect one more time...
Jacob? Oh, this isn't so bad. Anyways, let's hear from a few of our favorite teachers on how they've gotten through this difficult transition to online learning.
My name is Dr. Calmer, and I'm a physics teacher here at Beckman High School. I've taught, this is my first year at Beckman. This is my 12th year of teaching, and I've been teaching physics for the last 6 or 7 years, potentially. The first day of virtual school for 2020 is kind of a strange question, because virtual learning has occurred in different capacities all along the way. Teaching science in a virtual environment is very different. It seems a lot harder to teach a science course that involves labs, more experimentation, things that really you can only get from tangible objects that are in a science location. There's a lot of stuff that science classes use regularly as instruments of learning. And a virtual simulation doesn't doesn't fit as well as running a lab.
My name is Wayne Dolan. I'm a teacher of English. I teach AP English and English 1 CP. This is my 26th year teaching, as the gray in my beard will indicate. And I'm one of the founding teachers, one of the proud founding teachers at Beckman High School, I should say. Some of the first things I experienced in a digital year are the same issues you experience in a non-digital year. For instance, the butchering of the names, which every teacher tries the best to get around. I did that in a non-digital way, and I did it in a digital way. So in some ways, it's more of the same. And so the hallmark of the opening was compassion, understanding, tolerance, to really not get upset. In a non-digital realm, if a student comes in late, typically they have a little bit more control, but when your internet goes south, that's kind of out of your hands at a lot of times.
You really do, I can see how people perform on stage because you really feel an audience, and not having that makes it a little bit challenging because you don't know where to stop and when to move forward. So I can just like talk about ideas and I don't know if like half the room is lost and totally zoned out versus, you know, if it's live, I can pick up on that and say, okay, well let's revisit this, or let me pick out a demo. I'll like go through one of these cabinets and pull out a device and say, this is what I mean.
I think the part that's challenging is I see students that turn on their camera, and I guess I would call it the path of least resistance, and they're gonna turn on their camera and they're gonna be dutiful. And you know, I'll applaud that and I'll take what I can get in this digital world, but I see they're not trying to be engaged. And I don't know, I've often tried to get into the students' mind about this. I don't know if they think that we as teachers can't see or aren't aware of it and that we shouldn't care, but I think the tricky part is to understand and try to not take that personally, to say that, okay, I'm offering this knowledge and the student doesn't want it for whatever reason, and that's okay, to give them that space to not be interested and let that be okay.
We're a little bit more intentional about trying to build community. So some of those initial topics that we talked about were a bit more aligned with, let's just talk about what it's like to, like, you know, what are your goals? Here are my goals. And a little bit more of that sort of like banter, I guess, in a way, which I haven't always done before. So in a way it was kind of helpful for me because I realized like it's really important to kind of develop a sense of community in a classroom and build those relationships. And I was intentionally trying to build community, like try to bring it out more because we're so far away.
You know, I still meet with the teachers digitally, ironically, and the Beckman teachers are still giving their all and they're doing their best. And even though there are constraints with the virtual education, like they're doing their best to make it engaging, to make it exciting, and to still give students a top-notch education. Maybe it might not seem that teachers care through a screen because empathy doesn't translate so well, but there's love and concern about their students as much as there was before. There's just as much now.
Hey, you're back. Where'd you go?
I have no idea. I think I need a nap.
All right then, I think we're gonna have to end this episode here.
Thank you guys for watching.
And keep connected, Patriots.